Hello friends, myself Sangeeta Rajole from LG Institute of Computer Application. Today we are going to discuss transportation problem using R programming. This is a topic of operation research. Okay, it is transportation problem is what? It is a special case of linear programming problem. So first of all, we will see what are the outlines we are going to discuss today. First, we are going to discuss what is transportation problem. Then what is the mathematical model to formulate transportation problem, network diagram to represent a transportation problem, R packages which is used to solve transportation problem, and how to solve it by R programming. First of all, what is transportation problem? Transportation problem is a special case of linear programming problem where the objective is to minimize the cost of distributing the product from one source, from the n number of source or origin to the n number of destination points. Basically, the transportation problem is used to transfer the goods from one source to another source. In this particular thing, what we want to minimize the cost. How we can optimize this particular cost to get to transfer the goods from source to destination. Because of its special structure, the usual simplex method is not suitable for transportation problem. Because of this, it requires a special method to solve a transportation problem. Today we are going to see how we can solve this particular transportation problem. Now, the problem defines like finding a minimum cost distribution of a given commodity from a group of supply centers, that is I will start from one supply center till n supply centers to the group of receiving centers, that is destination, that is J, which starts from n 1 to n. Each source has a certain supply which is represented by S of I. Each destination has a certain demand which is represented by D of J. The cost of shipping from source to the destination is directly proportional to the number of units shipped. Now, transportation problem is used to minimize the total cost from one source to another destination point. Now, we will see a network diagram. How we can represent this particular network diagram? Basically, we'll take one example. In this table, the table is given number of sources, that is a particular product is going to be manufactured in Vapi and Pune, and the destination which is going to be transferred to Thane, Surat and Ahmedabad. This source Vapi can manufacture 240 products, can supply only 240 products as per this particular table. Pune can supply only 210 products, whereas the destination demands are given row wise, that is demand for Thane is 100 for both products, for from both this one, demand for Surat is 150 and demand for Anand is 200. Now we'll say how it is represented in a network diagram. Let us say we have a source, that is network diagram, that is we have taken two sources, one is Vapi and another one is Pune. Then next one, we have taken three destination points, that is Thane, Surat and Anand. Now, if you want to transfer the goods from source to the destination, then Vapi can transfer the goods to Thane, to Surat and to Anand. Where likewise, the Pune, for Pune also, it can transfer to Thane, Surat and Anand. This is a simple network diagram. Now we will represent the table values in this particular network diagram. Now suppose here the Vapi, source Vapi to Thane, the value is cell value is 5. Means from Vapi to Thane, if you want to transfer a good, the cost is 5 rupees. If you want to transfer from Vapi to Surat, it costs rupees 6. From Vapi to Anand, it costs rupees 7. Per unit cost is given. Now, Likewise, we will see for the source, Pune. If you want to transfer goods from Pune to Thane, then it takes 4 rupees cost per unit value. Then from Pune to Surat, it takes 8, and Pune to Anand, it takes 2. Now, the supply is given, the last column, that is supply is given for Vapi and Pune. For Vapi, it is 240 and for Pune, it is 210. And for demand, for destination, the demand is given, that is for Thane, 100 rupees, 100 cost. Then next one, total cost is 100. Then for Surat, it is 150 and for Anand, it is 200. Now, this values which is circle, these are called as what? CIG. CIG is what? Cost per unit from source to destination. Now, if your total or total number of supply and the total number of demand, then it is equal. Such a problem, we call it as what? Balanced transportation problem. In the balanced transportation problem, total supply is equal to total demand. If you see another type of problem which come across in a real life situations, that is unbalanced transportation problem. In unbalanced transportation problem, total supply is not equal to demand. Either the supply is greater, either the demand is greater. In such a situation, what we have to do to solve a transportation problem using in a operation research. Now, when the unbalanced transportation problem occurs, when supply is less than demand, it means supply is less than demand. Suppose in a same example, instead of 210 value, if it is 200, that time what we have to do, we have to add one dummy row. Here we are going to add one dummy row with the help of value, that is supply value is 10. Likewise, if a supply is greater than demand, it means your demand is less as compared to that of a supply. In this case, we have to add dummy column. Here, dummy column, how you are going to add? Suppose a demand for Anand is only 150. It means what? The supply is not equal to demand. Now, supply is not equal to demand. 50% is less, 50 units is less in a demand. So, to make it equal, what we'll do? We will add one dummy column. With in that dummy column, we are going to insert a dummy value, that is for demand is 50 rupees. 50 units, sorry. Now, for this particular thing, how mathematical model is constructed on from this particular network diagram. In the mathematical model, Xij is what? Unit trip from plant I to the J. Whereas, I is what? Data sources. Here the sources is what? Vapi and Pune. V stands for Vapi and P stands for Pune. And J notation is used for destination, that is Thane, Surat and Anand. T for Thane, S for Surat and A for Anand. So we will minimize the cost. So first of all, we are going to write an objective function, that is minimize Z. In minimize Z, we are going to write phi x v1. It means for from source Vapi to Thane, the cost is 5 rupees. Plus, from Vapi to Surat, the cost per unit value is 6 rupees. From Vapi to Anand, the cost per unit value is 7 rupees. Plus, we are going to add the second source, that is, from Pune to Thane, the per unit cost is 4 rupees. From Pune to Surat, the per unit cost is 8 rupees. From Pune to Anand, the per unit cost is 2 rupees. When you multiply CIG, multiply by XIG, then we will get an objective function. When you want an objective function, there are some constraints are there. That constraints are, here there are only two constraints we will construct in a transportation problem, that is supply constraints and demand constraints. Whereas supply constraint is what? That is V1, that is from Vapi to Thati, Surat and Anand, that is a Vapi supply constraint, and from Pune to Thane, Surat, Anand, that is a Pune constraint. Means, if at all the value of a supply is given, more than that value, we cannot supply. Because if you are manufacturing a fixed amount, that amount only we can supply to that particular destination point. Likewise, the demand is given. The demand can vary. If a demand is greater than here, the demand for Thane is what? That is XV1 plus XP1, which is equal to 100. Demand is what? 100. The next one, the demand for Surat is XV2 plus XP2, which is equal to 150. Then demand for Anand, that is what? XV3 plus XP3 is equal to what? 200. And when you want to get this particular constraint, all values should be greater than or equal to 0. Means either the value should be a positive value or a value should be a negative value.